that part of a leader, I too, I can do little more. And as a result of that, if you see a single fault in the life of pastor, then you, the follower, we started, let me copy him a little bit. The person that is following us said, let me copy a little bit. The person that surrounded us in the choir said, let me follow them a little bit. You will see, by the time we draw the circle together, everybody have been following somebody else. And as a result of this, a lot of things has come into the church. And perfection started. Then Jesus now look at that. If that be the case, don't look at anybody. If you have respect, you have respect because God says so. If you are humble, you are humble because God says so. If you are given to the church, you are given to the church because God says so. If you are loyal to the word of the Lord, you are loyal to the word of the Lord because God says so. If there's nothing you cannot offer in order to get to the kingdom of heaven, you are offering it not because it is your own will. Not it is because of your own character. Because God says so. And that's what Matthew said. Matthew didn't look at anybody. He looked at Jesus Christ and he said, today, I will host you. Everybody can accept with me that when Matthew was a tax collector, he was not the only one that was collecting tax. He was not the only one that saw Jesus Christ. By the time he decided that I will follow Jesus, he didn't look at anybody. He humbles himself to Jesus Christ and to say, okay, I will pay back everything I've collected in 4 times by looking unto Jesus, and he didn't regret. Everybody must say he's foolish. Everybody must say he has worked hard on those money. Everybody may say that even to embezzle money is not easy. For him to embezzle money to that extent, it was a work. But he said, no. I'm not going to look at anybody. I'm going to look at Jesus Christ. And no matter what anybody can say, and that's what Paul too was doing. That I have my work, that work is enough for me. You are looking at me, I have position in Jews. There's nothing I cannot do. I can kill, I can rise up in my own way. I can pardon. But when God captured him, he didn't look at those people whom he can say, he can command that, go and kill them. Now Paul become a servant to them. He looked at everything at the end. He said, in order to win the Gentile, I become Gentile. See, in order to win them into Christ, he become low. He lower himself. What am I saying? Anytime you are looking at a single human being, that if this person can do this, if that person can do this, you have gone. And then, you know, devil has a way of, especially, let me count myself worthy. Some of us that we have decided that no matter what the case may be, I will follow this Jesus Christ. So that our tongue is going to be holding us to our commitment. Devil has a way. I remember when I woke up in this morning and a leader came to me and I look at his life and I said this. After all, he is a leader. The person devil fight most to when you listen to this message, and even when I woke up this morning, every time I try to communicate to God, he is like, the trial, the tribulation along the way is becoming too much.
What can I do, Lord? But that's the Christian journey we have taken. That's our commitment.
Other may take it lightly.
It is not light. I won't deceive you. And Jesus Christ said, there's tribulation. Part of that tribulation is to conquer sin. But he said, be cheerful, because I've conquered the world.
So if we hold on to the blood of Jesus Christ, if we hold on to God, and we do not look on to human being, you obey all his word, whatever you are doing it for God's sake, not for woman's sake.
Aaron said, every one of us should be present in the DC. You are not doing it for Aaron, neither I.
You are doing it because God said you should respect your leader.
Who are in Christ?
Even not only those people who are in Christ, your secular leader. The Bible makes it clear that you should respect them. So if you obey whatever any arrow says, it's not because you are gentle. You are not gentle. You don't fear arrow. You fear God. And when you fear God, you will fear arrow.
First verse. So my dear brethren, my dear, let us always know that what we are doing that look like we are foolish, do not forget what the Bible says. The foolishness of God is better than wisdom of man. Not that we are foolish. Your wife may tell you that, my dear husband, why are you doing this? Why are you doing this? Why are you so dumb?
If you can quote a verse in the Bible for your wife, know that you are on the righteous way.
Your husband will call you and say, why are you lessening my value? This is me. You have to have a little ego so that people can know that I have a good wife. But if you can show it to your husband, that this is what the Bible says, that thou shalt not proud, that obedient to your leaders. My dear brother, let that wife remain where he is, remain to where God is. And God is going to help everyone of us in Jesus' name. And the grace of the Lord will be sufficient for all. And we will not deceive you. I keep saying it every time we meet. The road is narrow and it's challenging. And Jesus Christ let us know.
But the case there is this.
We are going somewhere, which is kingdom of God.
If through tears, I'm going to get to the kingdom of God, I'm ready to be crying till I get there.
That's why I'm going to be welcome. Whom I know is a God of reward. And he will reward every one of us according to the work of our hand and according to his grace in Jesus' name. Today, once again, for some of us that we are workers, we see the message of our role, that we should preach on the great reward of true obedience. When he picked this, I was not there. You remember it was on last Saturday I was talking to us about obedience. And that's how you know that the spirit aid the spirit. I never thought he was thinking in that way. So, and then he said we should submit what I should have done is to have changed my Bible verses. But it was this morning I was thinking about it. I said, so the same thing I preach on that Saturday is what I'm still going to preach today. But the word of the Lord never old. It's new day and every day. So as a result, we will still go back to that Jeremiah. I will speak to us today about the great reward of true obedience. The great reward of true obedience. It is my belief that by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit will continue to communicate with every one of us in Jesus' name. Devil is a liar. And we are going to win the battle. As deeper life of charity is concerned, we are winner in Jesus' name. And devil is not going to prevail upon any one of us in the name of Jesus. Jeremiah 35. Jeremiah 35. I may not read everything, especially most of us who are workers. We have discussed this in the workers' meeting. 1 to 19. The word of which came unto Jeremiah from the Lord in the day of Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, saying, Go unto the house of the Rechabites, and speak unto them, and bring them into the house of the Lord, into one of the chamber, and give them wine to drink. As have told us in the workers' meeting, the Rechabites, they are sheep rearer. They have sheep, they are like a cattle farmer. So what they do for Israelites, their tribe, is like the tribe we call nomadic in our own area. They move from one place to another. People that move from one place to another, you know, a lot of challenges they are going to meet. In the time there's cold, in the time the weather is hot, in the time they have worked so well and they are tired, in the time it seems like they need enjoyment after working a lot of time, then God look at this. What can I know that flesh will demand from these people that will let them easily fall? And then it is from that area why they can easily fall, their trial comes. You know, somebody that has gone during the from the morning to 4 o'clock, rearing animal in the sun, then come in the evening, like our own soda, is like wine to the unbeliever. And then they are so tired. Oh, just the God that might have been thinking, let me try them the way Esau will try. And Esau failed the test. What thing I want us to learn from this place? It was something, as message we listen to today, it was something that you demand, anxiety. It was something that you are thinking about, having money. It was something you are looking, having a beautiful wife. It was something you are thinking about, having a good husband. It was something you are thinking about, being famous. It was something you are thinking about, I want to make sure I take care of my family. It was something you are thinking about, I want to make sure my children, they survive. All of them, they have this. It's from that place your trial will come. It's not a cause. I don't know if I told us some things in this church, that there are some people that if you give 1 million on the floor and then you test them, maybe they are going to steal that money. They will pass that through 1 million, they won't steal it, no matter what you can do. They are moral. But some of them, you cannot put their cousin, who is a female, you cannot say, please, take care of this female for me. They will sleep with that female. There are some people like this. There are some people, there's nobody they can never sleep with. Even if their daughter is careless. I've seen even a friend that told me that. Now a father wants to sleep with her. But that kind of people, if you put $1 million, I mean, you put $1 million on the floor, they will not steal it. And there are some people, they will never play with any woman except their spouse. Even their spouse may be complaining of intimacy. But anything they can do to have money, they are ready to do it. Even if come to sacrificing their wife to have money. So your trial will not come from what you do not like. And I will say I've started again. I wouldn't have. I like making myself an example. So that you know I know myself more than anything. About 2 weeks now, I've been telling Brother Steven, please do not let us have our fellowship because I want to pass mass. I was the one that we insist that we must do this as fellowship. Why? Devil knows until now, that thing is being revealed to me. I never thought in that way. But I will still tell you something I learned from that. But devil knows that's what is in my priority for that particular period. And I'm ready to sacrifice my anything I want to do for the Lord to pass that mass. You know, I do not know until now. But one thing I want you to know is this. When you are with God, He's ready to bail you out. That's why we always say, know the kind of... You know, some of you, when you say you have secret, I only think of what secret you have. To be sincere, if there's anything any one of you do not know about my life, I'm telling you, Sissy, go and write it down. And if at any day you discover it, you say, no wonder. All what I know about this man, so this thing is hiding in his life. And he told us one day, he said, and you know that you will, if you come on to me, you say, Pastor, so you can do this. And it is a sin. The list in America will follow his credit card. I think I've given Brazil even once again. Except when we are playing. That don't spend my money. That's the least thing. There was a day our state pastor came. And they want to send me on an errand. And he said, Pastor Matthew, go and do photocopy of this credit card and all this. I was surprised. That this thing you want to buy for me, this thing you want, just do the one photocopy, do the other. Pastor, nobody does that. He said, what is credit card? My dear brother, go and write it down. I don't say if you want to have secret, you shouldn't have it. I don't say if you want to have something you are consuming, you shouldn't have it. But I want to tell you, if there is truth, if there is anything pure, there's nothing to hide. I was speaking to all of you at my church. Thank God they have gone upstairs. I was speaking to my wife recently. I said, okay, even when you are sleeping with me, you tell Pastor Dada, know that I have a wife, I'm sleeping with him. If I don't sleep with her, I won't have that children. So it's not a big deal. If I tell him or not, you know that I'm sleeping with my wife. It's not a big deal. So just if we are saying, just like because something like that is like immorality. But it's not a big deal, he knows. So what else is the secret in the Christendom? Tell me. think there is something we are concerning or we are keeping, especially for your father in the Lord or for your people in the Lord that can guide you, go and look at the Genesis. There's something wrong. Let us be sincere. And that's why many people, church like this, they don't want to stay. But I will rather beware Almighty God is going to be teaching me the truth to make it to the kingdom of God, so that my effort in this world will not be in faith in Jesus' name. So the recovers, God wants to take them from the area whereby he thought this will be easier for them, because they are cattle rearer, they must have been tired. Let me test them with wine so that they can drink. They will feed through that one, they will be refreshed. But these people pass the test. We are going to pass the test in Jesus' name. We listen to that. I wish we listen to that message very well. The devil will come in area whereby he believes that's the area why you cannot, it's an ongoing area for you to pass the test of the Lord. That the area where area devil will come. But whenever that kind of things came, remember the word of the Lord. Remain firm. Fear God and not human being. If you put fear into human being, immediately that human being leaves, you are going to do whatever that's against the will of the Lord. And we have seen. Not because you sin openly, make it sin. Or maybe because you sin secret, make it sin. Sin is a sin. So if you do something when human being is not there, is it a sin? You even better do it openly so that people will know that that's your character. So that one quickly, let me go to the point one, which is the genesis of our trial as a believer. The genesis of our trial as a believer. After all, God himself tests us to confirm our faithfulness and our seriousness with him. Many times, it will be from even whomever you never thought that will be the genesis of the test to you. That's when the test will come. But if you remain firm by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, every one of us, we are going to make it to the end in Jesus' name. Giving our life to Jesus does not mean we will not face trial. And giving our life to Jesus does not mean, I remember the person that converted me. He said, if my wife is going outside and the man called him, and if my wife came back, I mean, came back and come and tell me that, oh, see, this person called me, I won't beat my wife, I won't beat the man. I won't do anything. The only thing is the reaction of my wife to that man will show if she's a Christian or not. Because if I try my wife, although we know in our church we dress to the extent that when everybody see you, they run away. That is a Christian. But it was from another religion. The person that converted me is not from deeper life. And he said, if my wife dressed very well, and then she will be attractive to other men. If they call him, I mean, if they call her, it's for her to know that Jesus Christ is in me. I don't need to do fornication. I don't need to do adultery. It is not because he fear me. That thing is in his blood. So, because we are Christian, make us easily attractive. And then, My dear brother, my dear sister in the Lord, for about 3 months or 2 months now, I've seen that many people, we call them a Christian, but if you really go into their life, there's a lot of sin. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. So, mean that we are a Christian or we are in the midst of Christian does not mean that we are not going to face a trial. The trial will surely come. It may be to compromise. It may be to lie. It may be to do a secret fornication. It may be to do a secret adultery. It may be a secret of not being faithful to God. It may be a secret of this and that. That we are Christian does not mean the trial will not come. And then if you are not tested, who are you? If Jesus Christ himself is being tested, then why are you not going to be tested for your faith? Whom are you following? Who is your Lord? Who is your Savior? Who is your Christ? Who is the one that is finisher of your thought? I mean, of your faith. If you are not tested, and Jesus Christ was tested. So if Jesus Christ was tested, by dear brother and dear sister in the Lord, know that no one among God can avoid it. You are going to be tested. And do not think it's devil. God himself may want to try your faith. In the book of John, chapter 16, 33. John 16, 33. Before then, because of our time, I wanted to read for us Matthew 4, 1 to 11. But instead of Matthew, and all of us know what happened in the book of Matthew 4, 11, devil came unto Jesus. And devil tested Jesus Christ. But what made Jesus Christ succeeded? The word of his mouth. He asked the word of the Lord. Nobody was there. And do not forget, they are calling you a little Christian. They are calling you Christian. That means a little Christ. Because they see Jesus Christ in you, that's why they are calling you a Christian. And everyone first shouldn't forget the meaning of Christ. Where we get Christian from is for Christ, Christian. So the reason why everybody is calling you Christian is that they believe you are acting in the way Jesus Christ is acting. So if you are acting the way Jesus Christ is acting, the way Jesus Christ was tested, you are going to be tested that way. Nobody was with Jesus. To the extent that they will see him like a magic man. If it is this, let me quickly bow down for this devil so that he can give me all the power of the world. Then the world will belong to me. And I know my Father in heaven will not reject me. Jesus Christ didn't do that. Nobody was with him, only devil. The same thing happened to Joseph. Samson failed on his own. So your trial may come the way Jesus Christ was tried, but by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we are going to overcome. And we are overcomer in Jesus' name. The book of John 16, 33. John 16, 33. John 16, 33. This thing I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation. That tribulation is your trial. The problem, the challenge there is how you face it. But you are going to overcome. I'm going to overcome in Jesus' name. Now lead me to point two, the genuine attitude of a Christian during trial. Genuine attitude of a Christian during trial. In book of Jeremiah 35, 6 to 10. Jeremiah 35, 6 to 10. Jeremiah 35, 6 to 10. But they said, "We will drink no wine, for Jonadab the son of Rahab, our father, commanded us, saying, 'You shall not drink no wine, neither you nor your son forever.'" That's the Rechabites. When trial comes, believers should not surrender to trial. The trial of what I'm going to eat, the trial of what I'm going to drink, the trial of I'm in this kind of situation, the trial of I need money, the trial of I need progress, the trial of I want to become this, the trial of I want to do that. That trial will surely come. As it come to Jesus Christ, that you are the king of the world. I know you as the son of God, but you know your father, God, has given me this world. And Jesus Christ confirmed it, that I know my God has given you to this world, but just bow down for me. You bow down for me, all this world I will give it to you. Just give me $5. If you give me $5, I will let you sleep with me. Just let me give you $100. If you give me $100, I will let you pass that exam. God, give me that portage. If you give me that portage, I will sell my mattress to you. Just give me what I want. If you give me what I want, I will forget Jesus Christ. Is it not because of Jesus Christ? Nobody will know. I will give it to you. That's all. But the pride will become unto me. And I will be able to say among the world, I will be able to say among the people, yes, I have arrived. My dear brother, my dear sister, no, let us be sincere. Let us be sincere. Anytime something like that come, look back. Look, the devil is here. And this is time for you to pick your race. When we are a child of God, the end of it doesn't smooth. Many people do it. You thinking they are making it, they are not making it. The Bible says there's a way. That's a very prosperous. Some said, when I look around to it, I was jealous. But when I look at their end, I said, no, God, let them do their prosperity. I will rather take you. And Samuel was looking after offending God. Instead of you, okay, what do you want to forward? Do you want? I will rather fall onto your hand than rather fall onto the hand of man. So my dear brother, my dear sister, it's rather you fall to the punishment of God than to the prosperity of human being. It's very short. They didn't do anything free. Devil doesn't give free. And each individual human being, we are angels of devil, if not Christ that is in us. And if that Christ is not there, my dear brother, my dear sister, go and write it down. There is nothing human being ever done that is free. Go and write it down. They are like an end. When we are taking care of end, we give them food. We give them food so that they can grow. Immediately they grow, what do we do? Palm. The pursuit starts. So if human beings want to get something from you, they are taking salvation from you. Simple as ABC. And this area, we need to be very, very careful. What is our attitude when that trial comes? The main farm. Whatever God cannot do for you, no human being can ever do it. Go and write it down.
And that one, let me remember. Whatever, I will preach on that one day.
Whatever human being God cannot do for you, no human being can ever do it. If he does it and you are praising him, except God sent him to you, and then if it is God sent, you will know there will not be an altar of sin. Immediately, there's a sin. My dear brother, my dear sister, pick your race.
It is cage. It is trap. It is everlasting crying. But by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, God is going to keep us in Jesus' name. And the grace of the Lord will continue to be sufficient for us in the name of Jesus. Let's keep praying for one another. There's nothing too bad that he cannot correct. Recently, about 2 weeks, I just observed myself that the way I'm going is just too wrong. This thing is becoming too wrong. How can you? To the extent that when that problem started, I said, anytime I want to write, I have to write, I'm the one that wrote. Anytime I want to write letter to some people, I remove pastor from it. Because I was just asking myself, why should it be me? Nothing, it's not something I cannot tell you, but something that you may believe it's confidential. Maybe it's a family matter, you may not know. It's not, trust me, if I want to say it just because of situation of the, I can tell you this is my thought, this is what I was thinking about. And I was thinking that these things will come too much for me as a child of God. It's not a big deal, I can say it. So do not think that go to hotel or anywhere to go and commit fornication or steal money, no. It's a battle of the heart. But guess the stage I was thinking that this thing is too much. Leave it to the hand of the Lord. Why should you be thinking this way? I'm not justifying myself, but I know many people must have gone through that one too.
So what am I trying to say? Joseph ran away.
My dear brother, my dear sister, that thing looked like gold. It looked like way. It looked like it's God that provided it. Run away from it. It's not God. My sister is not God. My family, it is not God. It is a trap. Because it looks sweet. Because it looks like something that is necessity at that particular period we are. And devil know that's the best way, this is the best approach to attack this man, to attack this woman. Run away. God will help you. The grace of the Lord will be sufficient for you. There's no doubt, everyone of us will know there's a kingdom of God. There's no doubt, everyone of us know that there's a way. Then why do you want to lose the kingdom of God? Because of your personal agenda. Because of your personal dream. Because of your ambition. Because your husband is punishing you. Because your wife is punishing you. Because you think you cannot achieve this, I cannot achieve it again.
and you want to sell your birthright. Jesus sold it. Till now, he never gained it back. But why, God, why will we be our tears? During that time, that does not make us an excuse. Because those people who are under the law, they are going to judge them under the law. Those people who are under the grace, they are going to judge under the grace. It's not an excuse. That during Esau, there was no Jesus Christ. But during our own time, there was Jesus Christ. But the grace we have under Jesus Christ, Esau does not have it. If Esau has it, Esau wouldn't have been killed. But now we have that grace. My dear brother, my dear sister, do not misuse the grace. And they will use you. He knows how to heal your wound. He knows how to compensate you. He knows that, yes, I know this, my son is passing through difficulty. I know he wants to make his way right. I know he wants to have a perfect relationship with me. I know he wants to walk on my way. But I know as a woman, it's very, very difficult for him. It may be as if he doesn't see you. But if we can take that decision and say, let God be God. If it's going to be God, let it be God. If it's going to be woman being, let it be woman being. I will hold on to woman, I will hold on to God. He will justify you. Is it not this word? Those people who hold on to that word, they die. The rich people, they die. Those who have money, they die. Those who does not have, they die. The little boy, die. The older one, die. The person that we think that can never die, die. The one we think that is good, he will never die, die. Those who have husband, die. Those who don't have husband, die. Those who have wife, die. Those who does not have wife, die. Those who have children, die. Those who does not have children, die. Tell me, who is not going to die? That we are risking our life for eternity. God will wipe people our tears in Jesus' name. And our testimony shall be full. Hold on to that cross. Look at that cross. Look at the death of Jesus Christ on the Calvary. It will save you. It will save me in the name of Jesus Christ. You will make it to the heaven. I will make it to the heaven in the name of Jesus Christ. And by the power and the blood of Jesus, all things we lost, all our captivity, God shall return in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, when the captivity of Israelite was returned, it was like a dream. These are the people that have been asking, sing your song for us. After all, you call yourself Jew, and you know, call yourself the son of Jehovah. We are among us, and sing your song. Some people blame them, that maybe if they have sung the song, they will have saved them. But no, they say, why should we sing the song of the Lord? In the land of a sin. Anyway, many people make interpretation to it, but you said, no, you are not deserving it. To me, the devil does not deserve your rights. And you will not give it to the devil in the name of Jesus Christ. The genesis of trial as a believer. When Jesus Christ was going to heaven, he assured us that we shall face tribulation, but to be cheerful because we have conquered the world. You are going to conquer. And you are conquering. That tribulation will surely come. I've told us, as a Christian, as a family, it may come from your husband. It may come from your wife. It may come from your children. It may come from your father, biological father. It may come from God himself. When it comes from God, you know that it's going to... It's like an exam. When you pass it, it's a promotion. It's going to promote you in the name of Jesus Christ. It's going to promote me in the name of Jesus Christ. Joseph was tested. But he passed. What happened to him? He became the governor in another foreign state. Not even in his own state. In another foreign one. That's how far God can take you to. That's where you hold on to this world. You know his father loved him. And then you know when father loves his son. That's why the other people they are on the feed. Taking care of the sheep. But his father loved him to the extent that he always keep him to him. You know when father loved his son? Joseph, this is what God says. That shall not do this, that shall not do this. Joseph, this is what God says. That shall not do this, that shall not do this. Joseph, you know I love you. Look at this dress. It is only you I make it for. But there's still something that is very sweeter than this cloth I'm making for you. God says in our book, in the book of Jew, that as you are Jew, you must not do this, you must not do this. Do nothing. That's grace come on the Joseph only. Because we act according to what we are here. And he acts according to what he has heard from his father. That when a woman wants to tempt you, my dear son, run away. The trial come on to Joseph because his father has so loved him. He has kept him to his side and he has been telling him, this is the Lord of you, this is the Lord of you, this is the Lord of you. My son, keep it in your heart. Don't let it go. And when the trial comes, the word kick. And Joseph ran away. So you can only succeed if you keep on to the Bible. Do not keep to the wisdom, do not keep to the understanding of human being. God will see us through. God will see you through in Jesus' name. God will see me through in the name of Jesus Christ. Joseph was tested because of his loyalty to Almighty God. God, devil know where you are going. He know your destination. He went ahead to go and wait. That this is a crossroad. I will see if you are going to pass. Whenever you are being tested, do nothing is from devil. As a child of God, most of our tests come from Almighty God to prove our faith. The apostasy has come now. And the non-apostasy is this. Every Christian, when they are not tested, they can claim that they are Christian. In alternative, every Christian, when they are tested, they fail. Then the question you need to ask yourself is, as I'm going home, as I'm going to be thinking about this world, including me, that apostasy still rejected?
Can I be part of the evidence that if every Christian is being tested, they fail? Or I'm the part of evidence that if every Christian has been tested, it becomes so strong?
The law of the cry, the joy of the Lord is our strength. He will keep us to the end. Who does to the word of the Lord? You couple, when you wake up in the morning, read the word of the Lord. Read it to the children. Let Jesus Christ be proud of you, like he was proud of Abraham, that I know if other people, they do not keep my word, Abraham will not go away with my word without sharing it with his children. Make it as an assignment. God will take care of our children for us in the name of Jesus Christ. And we shall eat the fruit of our labor in the name of Jesus Christ. Then, the garden of obedience. What I mean by G-U-E-R-D-O-N is the reward of our obedience. You know what? We have read that in the book of Jeremiah 35, 18 to 19. What God did for them, he said, because you do this, because you are not drinking this wine, you have gone into the sheep, you are feeling thirsty. You have done a lot of this thing, you are feeling thirsty. But instead, you keep my word. I'm following and I'm telling you, you rabbit, no, your family will never lack any man. Till ever, now, forever and ever, before me. Do you know how I interpret it? Anytime they want to go wrong, that man will go and tell God. Do you remember what you promised my God? I know my sibling, they have done this, they have done this. But remember, at this particular time, when you tested them, do you remember how they are found before you? God, please forgive them. Who knows? To this level, to this seed. That's why Israel, you know, they are farmer. And there was a time, you know, by the time they come back, the area was desert. After they have gone on exile, then they came back, the area was desert. What happened to the agriculture? It boom. Israel never depend upon anybody to eat. All this blessing has been upon them. So I'm telling you, my dear brothers and sisters, my dear sister, if you can hold on to that word of God, it will surprise you. It will surprise me. And our testimony shall be full in the name of Jesus Christ. It may be so hard, but look at one of the blessings of God to those people who obey him. Abraham was blessed. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham from heaven a second time and said, I swear by myself, if you can do my will, if you can obey my will, if you can do what is in this Bible, and you go according to what I've said, I swear by myself, declare the Lord unto you, unto me. And that's why many of us, it looks like our problem does not have solution. It has worldly solution. But because we hang on the neck of the Lord, and we said, no, I will not go back. That's why people are, you think people are mocking us. No. But Bible said, look at it. I swear by myself, declare the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, because you have not done this, you have lost you have not denied me your sacrifice of faith. Because you have done it, this,
You have not led, you are not hold on to your flesh, for your fleshly wants. Because you have done this, you are not hold on to your own will. Because you have done it, you are not hold on to your own self-righteousness. Because you have done it, you are not hold on to your own righteousness. Because you have done this, you are not hold on to your own want. Because you have not done it, you are not hold on to your own pleasure. Let everything go. That's why I was the one that gave you this song. I was the one that gave you this thing I was even asking for. And I was the one that was giving you this thing that said, keep on my behalf. And I come to try you. And Abraham, this thing that is so precious, this thing that is so important, this thing that people of the world see, that they are looking for a child. They even want their child to be firstborn. And when that child is a firstborn, it's a male. They feel happy. Then not only that your child is the only firstborn now, your child is a male. And that's the only one son you have. And I said, Abraham, sacrifice this child for me. And you sacrifice it. And I ask you, sacrifice this thing that is your flesh heart. That's your own want. That's what you are desire. That's what you have pleasure on. Sacrifice it to me. Let it go. And you do it. Look at what he said to Abraham. I swear by myself, declare the Lord, that because you have done this, I have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendant as numerous as the star in the sky and as the sun on seashore. Your descendant will take possession of the city of their enemy. My dear sister, my dear brother, let us think twice. This is not the first time I will tell you this. This is not the second time. This is not the third time. I know my agreement with the Lord. I know my covenant with the Lord. And if not, I've told you how all my beginning to this level. And even all of you have seen it, it's not the matter of life. There's no way you will move with me, you will not see it. That everything about me is the God grace. And the covenant is this. Matthew, if you walk, even the little you are seeing, is that the little you walk with me? And that's what that is baffling me throughout last 2 weeks. It was a real problem on my flesh. Because I know, and I know why the trial is coming. And I discussed with our father in the Lord when he came. And I've decided that God, if I can pass through, I don't need to wait. But I was telling God, if I can pass through this semester, I need to battle all these things. And you need to help me. But I don't need to wait to the end of the semester. But sometimes when things happen to me, and it happens, it's like, hey, God, this is why you allowed this thing to happen to me. Thank God I'm not condemned. And then the Bible is not telling, in that telling, I surely bless you and make you descendant as numerous as the star in the sky and as the sun on the seashore. Your descendant will take possession of the city of their enemy. My dear brother, the same thing is telling Abraham. If you do not do this, do not forget, I say we are under the grace. Abraham was judged according to law. We are judging according to Jesus Christ. But when that woman came, what was Jesus told him? Go and sin no more. Esau did not have that opportunity. Samson did not have that opportunity. Even that woman, they will have used the same law to kill him. It is because Jesus Christ was around. So the grace that appeared to that woman is appearing to us and is telling us, go and sin no more. And then the east said, Ethan said to Abraham, now this area, why? We are having that problem. Abraham, you do not obey this word.
the angel of the Lord called to Abraham from heaven. That means the angel of the Lord will not speak to Abraham from heaven. Because he did not obey the word. You are saying the genesis of our problem. And then he said, I swear by myself, God will not even swear to a sinner. You are saying the genesis of our problem. Then the Bible said, declare the Lord that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, because you have not done this and you withheld your opinion, you withheld your heart desire, you withheld your what you want, you withheld what you think is the best for you, you withheld what you think it will be prosperous for you, and you take my own will, you take it away, then it will say, I will surely not bless you and make your descendant, I will not make your descendant as numerous as stars. Do not forget, I'm not forcing anybody. I'm saying this word God will have told Abraham. And that's why I was saying last time that when Abraham blessing is mine. But to sacrifice like an Abraham become a problem unto us. And through your offspring shall a nation on earth will be blessed. That should have mean Abraham, because you do this, and that's why all of us, we are having one problem or the other, because we disobey the word of the Lord, but we want the blessing of the Lord. Then can negative times plus, what is it? It's negative. You can see the reason why. So we are not the one that is, it's not God. It's our compromising. It's our disobedience that is following us, that get us to where we are. But he's a God of mercy. He's setting us free. And by the time in the love of Lord Jesus, we are going to love. But can we say we should be under the grace and continue to sin? When we do not know, we do not know. But now we have known. And the correction, restitution, every other thing must be made. God will help me. God will help in Jesus' name. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, our joy is at hand. We get to the destination in the name of Jesus Christ. Including me, God will wipe away my tears. As it's happening under your roof, it's happening under my roof. As it is happening to you, it's happening to me. As you are battling it, I'm battling it. And then you know why it is common. There's something we call common factor that everybody is seeing in our life. That common factor is Jesus. And as far as that common factor is there, do you know the most person we think that God should take to the kingdom of heaven is Jesus. Then Jesus said, okay, if you don't have problem, please come on to me. I will share part of that problem. I will give you part of it. But what make them different? What make them to where they are today? They decided that no matter what the case may be, bye-bye, word. So the higher the problem is coming, the higher they are getting promotion. And the higher that our promotion starts today in the name of Jesus Christ. The song is coming to my mind. And I know my brother will know it. But I want you to know, Jesus does not yield to Satan's instruction. That shall not yield to it. He shall surely judge Satan on the day of judgment. Jesus will tell you, all of us will judge Satan in the day of judgment in Jesus' name. My dear sister, my dear brothers, God is communicating to you, not human being. If you look at human being, you are going to fall. If you look at that one particular person, you are down. If you look at your leaders, or I'm not saying you shouldn't look at all them, like look at us. Like when the children make this kind of hair, I say, did you see it in the head of your father, or do you see it in my head? You know that one is a physical. But there are a lot of things that are still there, that even did they are battling. Then Jesus Christ is handling it for them. Then Jesus Christ is saying, if you look at that way, you will fall. Don't look at them. Look at me, the finisher of your faith. And if there's anything I, Jesus Christ, your Savior, have not done, I don't expect you to do it. So that Christianity, you will remain IAN, and that Christ will remain, will take away from you. And then if you are a member of this church, you know what IAN means. I am nothing. It is because of Christ is there, you become a Christian. Immediately we remove other IAN, it remains what? I am nothing. God will raise you up. God will wipe away your tears. Then, the mocker will mock, the jester will jest. Those who does not know where God is taking you to, they will call you a nonentity. They will call you a foolish man. They will call you somebody that does not have sense. But one with God is what? It's majority. To human being, it's very hard. But to God, it's possible. And that's why in the book of Luke, chapter 1, this verse 77 or 70 said, with God, all things are possible. There's nothing impossible with God. And then I want you to know that the foolishness of man, the foolishness of God, is better than wisdom of man. Then, one of my best verses in the Bible, John, if I'm still correct, one of my best verses in the Bible, John, I know it often, I just want to be sure that I, but that's those things that always keep me. John. Okay. John. Okay, I can't get it, but he said, okay. Thank God. I know it's still John chapter 6. John chapter 6, verse 60. Verse 60. Look at it. Let us open our eye. Let's look at our Bible. John 6, verse 60. Said this. Are we there? Are we there? Said. John 6:60. Many therefore of his disciples, when they had this, said, this is an hard saying. Who can hear it? The same way as you are thinking, why pastor go to this lens? Why pastor go to this deep? Why pastor go to... My dear brother, my dear sister, we shall be praying for one another. And we shall stand on the truth in Jesus' name. When Jesus knew him, said that his disciple murmured at it, he said unto them, does this word offend you? Does all what I've said today, does it offend you? Why can't you just search yourself and make amendments where it is necessary? And look at what the Bible says. What and if you shall see the Son of Man ascend up where he was? There's another question Jesus Christ asked them. Jesus Christ asked a question. Look at this. I've seen it. Verse 67. No, let's go to 66. When he got to the 66, said, from that time, many of the disciples went back and walked no more with him. From that day, many of his disciples, they went back. They did not come to the church again. They do not believe in God. This God we are going to be hearing, it's better for me not to come to that church again. But look at what happened. From that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. Then Jesus Christ now asked them, I'm not asking you. I'm asking myself. I'm asking you. I'm asking my wife. Although it's not the edition that we are speaking this message, I wish he to listen to it. And I'm asking myself. Then said Jesus unto the 12, will you also go away? Then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? My dear brother, my dear sister, our commitment is to whom shall we go? Look at what he said. And we believe and sure that you are that Christ, the Son of the living God. So the question is, will you also go away? But to whom shall you go? And just as to whom shall you go? If there's anything I've said that is not in the Bible this morning, tell me. Let us trash it together. Then it is at that level you will ask yourself, to whom shall you go? As you may be thinking that we eat armor today, the same way I mean, not that I pay back, same way too. And then if I've not been going all through this, I won't be able to preach it. I want you to know. And if anybody wants to say he has passed through any trial in this life, come and ask me. I've passed through, and I'm still passing through. But God will see you through. God will help you with your tears. And the power and the glory of Jesus will love. That's a reason for every situation that happens in our life. But if we can put it to the hand of the Lord, we shall get to the top. And we are getting to the top. Let us rise and pray. Call upon the name of the Lord. That by the power and the glory of Jesus Christ, His grace will be sufficient for us. My dear sister, my dear brother in the Lord, I wish I can be. It's like many of the time when I'm talking to you like my family, you misquote me. It's like pastor always see everything. It's like pastor does not, it's like he doesn't have control. He does, but I don't have any other family like you. There's a lot of things that can tell you, even as this message is coming, and I will tell you that this what happened, this one, that you will understand. I don't go outside. I don't have any other friend outside. I don't have any other family outside. In the church, I'm more closer to you than even how I'm closer to my family. Just because of Jesus Christ. Call upon the name of the Lord. All words that I've lost in my life, Father, return them unto me in Jesus' name. Wipe away my tears. Wipe away my tears. Let me find my level with you. Direct me on my way. Let your glory shine upon me. Let your mighty hand upon me. My dear brother, my dear sister, as you are facing the challenges I'm facing, this, there are some things I can tell you now and you will know. The reason why this message flow, the reason why there's no obstacle is, it's just a matter of time. God will take total control of the church. And the truth will continue to be preached. Call upon the name of the Lord. God, see me through. Let your glory be upon me. If there's anything I've said, if I tell you anything I've read, if there's any interpretation of the Bible, I want you to go home, go and pray. Take it, underline it. Ask me. Why, Pastor, this does not say this. God does not say this. God does not say this. I wish there's any accusing finger. Sit me down. Not because of me, just because of the kingdom of God. So that you can see me there, I can see you there. But the fact of the case is this. I want you to accuse me. I want you to sit me down. I want you to say your own opinion. But look at your eyes. I don't even want you to look at your eyes before you accuse me. Accuse me first. But after you have done that, my dear sister, my dear brother, look at your eyes. Look at your eyes. Look at your eyes. I'm going to take us there. God will preach the message into our hearts. And by the grace of the Lord, we'll make it to the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Almighty Father, we glorify your name. We have decided, O Lord, that we are going to hold on to you. Father, help us to the end. And let your name be glorified. Keep us, O Lord, so that your name can be glorified. And we can be a good example to the Gentiles. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. The service is over.